Good evening, and welcome to tonight's performance of the Faure Requiem. My name is Daniel Knight, I'm one of the choir directors at Plano East. My associate, Dana Goodenough, is back there turning pages. She will be not conducting tonight because she has an injury to her shoulder. We feel really bad for her. So do keep her in thoughts and prayers that will heal as quickly as possible, and she can get back to flinging these arms like we do over here. We would like to thank the staff at Candy Creek Presbyterian, music minister David Hayes, and the background on our soundboard course, and Pastor Andy Odom, for allowing us to be here this evening. I would like to invite you all to a small reception at the conclusion of tonight's work in the atrium, which is located just outside these doors to the right. There's many ways you can get there. That's the quickest way, but there also might be 160 kids going that direction, so you might want to go that direction. Some parents are wonderful performers and provide cookies, and we'd love for you to join us. We'll also have a booth set up with our Booster Club that would love to take any donations you would like to share with our organization so we can continue to have these concerts with our hired professional instrumentalists. We can take cash and, of course, checks made payable to PESH card users. Little history about this piece of music. There are actually three versions of the Faure Requiem. The original composition was completed and performed in 1888 and only consisted of five movements. Tonight you'll hear seven. The five were the Kyrie, the Sanctus, Pia Jesu, Magnus Dei, and the Nunc Paradisum. In 1893, he expanded the piece and added two pieces with baritone solos, the Offertory and the Liberame. I'm guessing he had a baritone friend and he wanted to sing some solos, so he added a couple pieces. Then again, in 1900, it was scored for full orchestra. It was mentioned this was possibly due to publisher pressures, just like current day, to get more ticket sales and performances in symphony literature. Tonight, we are performing an edition by John Rutter, who is sticking mainly to the original 1888 version of orchestration, with the exception of adding the two baritone works of the Offertory and the Liberame. If you were expecting the 1900, we're sorry. That was a little about the piece, now a little bit about how we decided to do the Faure or the Masterwork for our opening fall concert of the year. A little gutsy. It's quite simple, really. It was a hot summer morning. I was mowing the lawn, listening to my iPod. Not sure what I was really listening to at first, but then all of a sudden I realized I was singing along to the Faure Requiem, performed by UNT's Grand Chorus. So there I was, mowing my lawn, listening, conducting, probably going in all kinds of diagonals in the yard. And I thought, hey, I should text Dana and say, don't worry about picking out literature for the fall concert. I got it taken care of. So we decided that that was what was going to happen. And why, exactly? A requiem. What is a requiem? A mass for those who departed. I mentioned this to the students this past Monday night at our rehearsal after school. That I do not know what or why I picked out this piece of music. I have no idea why I'm mowing my yard. This song came on, this piece, for those who departed. This really made me think after the events that happened in Las Vegas on Sunday night. Who can explain why events like this happen? Who can explain why this song came on my iPod in mid-July? I don't know the answers. Here's a quote from Leonard Bernstein in 1963 after the assassination of President Kennedy that's been circulating around social media outlets for the past few days. And I think it's the perfect quote for tonight's concert. He said, "This will be our reply to violence, to make music more intensely, more beautifully, more devotedly than ever before. My hope is that in some way we are helping others through music this evening, that seeing the joy and beauty in this generation that is on this stage tonight will show light in a dark world. Thank you for coming tonight, and I hope you enjoy the Faure Requiem."
Thank you.
invite if you'd like to join us for some cookies. And again, thank you for giving us the opportunity to work with these wonderful kids you see up on stage. What a blessing. What a great piece of work. They're amazing. And thank you all. And after tomorrow, you have a 4-day weekend for the kiddos and 3 for the teachers. So much needed.